So it seems that after this beautiful artwork was leaked by Amazon, Nintendo decided to just bite the bullet and release it in its full resolution on the Legend of Zelda Facebook page. So you know what that means, let's crack it open and see what we can find. First off, what else can we see now that we have the full image to work with in a higher resolution? The obvious answer is this bridge spanning a large lake. Judging from the bridge's design, it's pretty easy to suggest that it's the same bridge we saw here in the 2014 Game Awards footage, which many people, myself included, assumed was the Great Bridge of Hylia from Twilight Princess. However, now we can see the bridge fully, it's a little more difficult to make this comparison. The Great Bridge of Hylia has three main great arcs, while this Zelda NX bridge appears to have many, as well as not being suspended hundreds of feet above the lake like in Twilight Princess. If this is, however, just a redesigned Great Bridge of Hylia, then this would make the giant lake it sits on Lake Hylia. Which makes sense, it does look pretty large and deep towards the left-hand side where it becomes a very dark shade of blue. Another thing that becomes more clear is this, a mysterious tower structure in the hills. And look, there are three more of them dotted around the landscape, here, here, and here. What are they? I pointed out in my initial analysis that these could be watchtowers like we saw in the Game Awards 2014 footage, from which Link can get a better look at his surroundings as well as potentially get a lot of distance using the sailcloth. Now, however, we get an interesting detail that connects the four towers we can see in this artwork. A strange blue glow. Sound familiar? Yeah, the same blue glow that seems to power the energy monster, Link's new arrow, and his mysterious Sheikah tablet. Yeah. It seems that whatever this blue glow is, it's going to have a huge impact on the game. The fact that they are all glowing seems to suggest that they have been activated in some way. Maybe Link can use his Sheikah tablet to fast travel to activated beacons over the map. Maybe they serve another purpose. Other than the fact that these towers are likely related in some way to the magic we've seen before, I can't really point out any more about them, except for pure speculation. We also get to see what is to the left of this church here, and the answer is, well, more cliffs. However, I've noticed something interesting about the way these cliffs are designed. They're stepped, sheer drops, then flat surfaces, then more sheer drops. Now, I'm not a mountain climber, but doesn't that seem like the perfect area for Link to take to with his newfound rock climbing ability? There's also something on the cliff here which I can't make out, other than it's similar to the other objects on the cliff below, perhaps a campsite. We also get a slightly better look at the castle now, and I stick by my suggestion that it's in fact Hyrule Castle under some sort of dark magic. Evidence for this comes with its positioning, close to where it was at E3, and the three tallest towers which match with both the E3 appearance and the classic appearance of Hyrule Castle. There are also four or more ridge or wall-like structures surrounding it, which I would suggest might bar Link's access to the castle, but they don't look like they'd stop this guy. Look at that face. Additionally, with the inclusion of the bridge, I think it's possible to guess at where this piece takes place on the map. Judging from the position of Lake Hylia and the bridge, as well as Death Mountain, it'd make sense for Link to be scaling a cliff somewhere around here, so around a mile to the left of where we see him riding. Another thing I want to note is the implication of Link's ability to scale sheer cliffs like this. If, like I've previously suggested, Epona will be able to carry Link's gear in this game, what does this mean for the hero when he does things like this? Perhaps climbing into areas Epona can't reach will provide both advantages and disadvantages for the player. They'll be able to access new areas, but with the side effect of having limited gear and travel options. Other than that, there really isn't anything new to analyse. If you've not seen my initial analysis, check it out since it'll sum up everything I haven't pointed out about this one. Let me know what you think about this new artwork in the comments. Cheers guys, and I'll see you next time.